Well, if you're going to build an international show jumping arena in the grounds of a castle, then why wouldn't you put a moat around it? Welcome to the fabulous main arena here at the Bolesworth Castle Estate. And today we've got coverage of their big class of the year. It's the Red Row Homes Grand Prix. This year, the show's been given 4-star international status. So no surprises then that it's attracted a truly world-class field. So Jimmy, what do you make of Bolesworth International Arena and the whole setup this show?
It's absolutely fantastic. Everything they've done here, you know, and they haven't missed a little thing, you know. Everything is all looked after well and, you know, well organised, you know. It's really, really good.
It's 4-star rating, so it has to be of a certain standard in prize money. So the prize money is good. The arena's, I mean, it's beautiful to look at, but it's good ground, it's lovely setting.
It's one of the best places in the world, that's for sure. And I think it's one of those places that's only going to get better. So it's just great, and it's only an hour away from home, which is something that us Northern riders haven't really experienced so much of. So it's great to be able to support the show, and yeah, long may it go on.
It's fantastic, the whole setting, and the arena's amazing. And yeah, it's great for show jumping in England to have a 4-star show.
Well, Scott, great to have you here. Your first time competing at Bolesworth. What do you make of the setup and everything?
Yeah, it's a fantastic ring, and I think it's great to have a 4-star here in Great Britain, and it's great to be able to compete here.
Yeah, because you do so much of your competing abroad. How does this show compare to the ones on the continent?
Yeah, well, I mean, it's right up there. I mean, the arena is fantastic, and it's a very unique ring. It's a different ring with the moat right round, and yeah, I think it's a really, really nice ring to ride in.
How important is it to have an international 4-star show in the UK? It's a new event, a new show. It's important to keep British show jumping at the forefront of the sport.
Yeah, definitely. It's extremely important, and it's important that the riders get a chance to earn world ranking points. And they only do that by getting 4- and 5-star international shows in Britain so that they can earn points to, you know, get into more shows. And so that's very, very important for Great Britain. And it's key to have those international shows in Britain.
And tell me about the horse you've got here today.
I've Hello Forever. He's been a little bit spooky in the ring all week, so we've worked him quite hard, so hopefully he's going to be a bit better today. But he's a really good horse, but he's only 9, a bit inexperienced, so this will be a test for him today.
Well, all the best, thank you.
Thank you, cheers.
Yeah, words from the world number one, Scott Brash, and it's a great crowd here at Bolesworth in the heart of Cheshire. Looking at this, the Red Row Homes Grand Prix, £60,000, and we're taking the top 13. And as it stands at the moment, the best score so far is Anthony Condon, very fast time four with Aristio. Spencer Rowe, Team GB, and hanging on there at the bottom is Jos Valoy for Belgium with 8. So now we're with Laura Rennick, Heliodor Hybris. This a young horse. Laura's had some fabulous form recently at Bourg-en-Bresse and in Sopot. And Tim Stockdale, this is a big course.
It's an extremely difficult course, and with it being a 3-round competition as well, it's quite a test to get into that second round.
Yeah, it's all about consistency over the 2 rounds and then going as fast as you can in the jump-off. Ah!
You saw Laura had that fence there. It's very delicate plank on that 4-stride distance. Just ran a little bit close to it, and just one toe on it has it down. It's a slightly different format. It's a little bit old-fashioned. In the olden days, 3-round Grand Prix were the norm.
Yes.
Not so much nowadays, and it's good to see it back because it does create that tension.
It certainly does, and what Laura's got to do, she's got to get home without another fence, but she's also got to pick up the pace.
When you've got faults on the floor, basically it's the time then that becomes the deciding factor to go into that second round. So she'll be cutting turns here, and you see that this is a trademark of Bob Ellis's courses, that he has a few switchback turns. She can save valuable seconds there because she knows time is of the essence.
Yes, she does. Right, last line. And this has proved tricky already, this last line.
Quite a committed 4 strides there, but a good jump out.
And we'll look at the time, 78.88, and that's a very good time. So Laura now looks as though she's climbing the rankings, could make it through to the second round. Just unlucky here, Tim.
Ran a little bit close. You saw Laura trying to support him and say, whoa, but there's not a lot to back the horse off. It's a very thin plank, so the horse just a little bit of a toe on it.
Will Funnel, the Billy Studs, Billy Congo. His great Grand Prix horse, back after a good break. And now Will thinks he's jumping as well as ever, but we'll have to wait and see.
Well, if experience is anything to go by, this pair have it all. You know, like you said, gold medal winners at the European Championships, and world's been around the block many, many times. So this is the type of competition that hopefully horse and rider experience comes to the fore. Quite a feisty horse in the way that he goes, and Will's always just resting him, but that's when he jumps his best. Ooh. Keeping a good momentum going through the turns. Got a turn back here. This is a very big vertical, so we just support him there.
That's the post box. Another of the great London 2012 fences designed by Kelvin Bywater. Now, what can we do? Steady, Will.
Got a little bit quick out of his hand there. We just didn't quite release behind and just, as you saw, nipped it off.
81.67, will that be good enough? Well, we've just got a long wait, Tim.
So here, look, just a little bit of the slightest of strokes behind. Probably got his attention caught as well, coming
Scott,
to the double.
Laura and last year's winner, Will Whittaker, on the rider picture there. They're looking on now for Italy. Rides for the Italian cavalry, Alberto Zorzi, Amor de Seigneur. And Alberto's had a very good show here at Bolesworth. He was very well placed in a big Grand Prix in Belgium last week.
Nine-year-old horse, bred by Darko.
Great Belgian stallion, ridden to great effect by Ludo Philipparts all those years ago.
A rider, a little bit inexperienced at the top level, but he's certainly building a name for himself. You saw him there just push a little bit to come out, but the horse responded very nicely, you know.
Very good.
Very good.
Such a great viewing position here, isn't it? On the bank, on the tops. It's just amazing. There isn't a bad view in the whole of the arena. Now, Tim, can this be the clear?
Just going to set him up to jump this last line four strides coming in. And then a big push out.
There's the first, Tim. Great round. So Italy give us the first. And that means he's definitely through to the second round, because it's the top 13, or it's the all the clears or the top 13. And they're going in reverse order, aren't they, in the second round?
And as you can see, there's not a lot of clear rounds, so this is very well placed.
Rob Whittaker, he's already won two very big rankings classes. He's got £15,000 in the bank already here at Bolesworth. But he'll be looking for the clear in this, the Grand Prix, Mandy Hall's catwalk.
Horse with a good temperament, in that he's got a little bit of a feisty nature about him, but you see when he's going to a fence, he is a pricked and he wants to lead them up. He's very, very careful. He has a massive stride, an absolute massive stride. And in jump-offs, that really gives him an advantage in the outdoor arenas, because he can actually open out the stride and use it to full effect.
Second in the Grand Prix at Royal Windsor, and then went down to Rome, part of the Victoria's team and the Nations Cup team in Rome.
Superb through the combination there. You can see that he's got also a little chin guard on there. The reason for that is because he likes to play with the martingale, and we don't want to get that caught in his teeth as he's jumping a fence. So that's there to stop that. So that's a safety feature with regards to the tack there. Not often seen.
Go on, Rob. Ah! Well, that was just a little bit careless, wasn't it, Tim?
A little bit out of shape on the turn, frankly. Just a little bit high in the body, and a little bit the same there going in. Just a little bit upside down. A little bit distracted there, and lost the frame and shape at the latter end of the course.
So three of the last four fences come down there. So his day is done, I would say.
I would definitely say so. And it didn't reflect the round, but you see here, look, head doesn't move, so he keeps his body a little upside down, and then he drags it off behind.
Well, it's proving a really tricky course this first round. Alberto Zorzi, the only clear so far, had around about 25% of the riders so far. Laura Rennick and William Funnell, both for Great Britain, are well placed with just one pole down, but plenty of riders still to come. Stay with us after the break. Well, welcome back to Ashford Farm Bolesworth International Grand Prix. We've had two clears since you've been gone, one for Ireland, Trevor Breen, and one for Luxembourg, Christian Weir. In fact, there was almost two clears for Ireland. Former world champion Dermot Lennon, ever so close, but he had the final fence down. It's proving a tricky first round. Daniel Nielsen for Great Britain is in the arena, so let's head back to Nick, our commentator.
Thanks, Ali. Yeah, Dan Nielsen, new partnership, but they are building very well indeed, Stride Simba.
Dan's a class jockey. He's ridden at the top level now for a number of years. And like you said, Nick, he's rebuilding his string. But this is a very promising horse. And
oh,
a little bit there, a little bit quick over the shoulder. Just had a little rub in front.
Now he's got to get home, Tim, without having another one, hasn't he?
That's right. He's got to up the tempo, try to get his eye on the clock, as it were, and try and get himself onto the second round. That means a quick time, but he's gone quite wide there, which I'm surprised about.
Now, this tricky last line.
Well, what he's got to get here, he's got to get nice and straight, because the double is four strides afterwards, and that's very committed to four. And then a big push out. Made
right.
A good job.
Now the clock. That's all important. 81.22. At the moment, he's in the top 13, Dan Nielsen and Stride Simba.
See here, takeoff just, oh look, the slightest of toes. Horse again are probably looking at the next rail.
So those are the three clears definitely through. One for Luxembourg, one for Italy, one for Ireland. And then the fastest of the four folders, Laura Rennick, Dermot Lennon and Vicky Gullickson, young Vicky Gullickson, who was equal first in the puissance here the other night. Viego Lezert.
Well, congratulations, Trevor. Talk me through your round.
Yeah, I'm absolutely over the moon with Old Town KC. He jumped out of his skin. He's been in good form all week. He was eighth in the 155 Friday, so he's continued that on today. And he tried really hard for me and felt super all the way around, so I'm thrilled to bits of him.
It's causing a fair bit of trouble, though. Is that a surprise to you?
Not really. I mean, it's a four-star Grand Prix. It is big, which you would expect, obviously. The verticals are certainly full up to height 160. So, yeah, I mean, when you get to that height, there's always going to be mistakes.
And that final fence is definitely the one that's proving the nemesis for lots of riders.
Yeah, it just seems to be the red row oxer. It backs them up. It's quite a big filler underneath, and they go quite high and land short. So then you tend to have a long four strides into the double, which is catching a few horses out, I think.
So now Keith Short. He was fifth in this Grand Prix last year with this lovely 12-year-old Mystic Hurricane. Combination that were in electrifying form in Austria, in Magna Racia, and also at Arena UK last week. Could he be the first clear for Britain, Tim?
They're a really strong partnership. Now, Keith had an awful accident last year.
12 months ago.
Yeah, he broke his pelvis and... And, you know, a lot of riders would not have come back after such a horrific injury. And credit to both horse and jockey, they've picked it up and they're having a tremendous season. So,
little rub there. Yes, they are. And it was so unfortunate for him because he'd just been selected to represent Great Britain on a Nations Cup team. Then he breaks his pelvis and he's back and vying for that position again.
Yeah, jumping a good round here. Slightly unorthodox style of both horse and rider. Keith keeps a little bit of a slightly upright position, uses a little bit of hand over the fence. The horse wouldn't be ideal in the way they use his back. Be very careful.
No.
And lots of scope.
Three fences to go before Britain's first clear, is it?
Big push now.
Shot tip. Shot, wasn't it?
Fabulous, fabulous round. And you see Keith giving a horse back. He knows that was all went well. That went right a plan.
So popular clear, 80.34 the time as well, the second fastest.
It's a packed crowd here, and Keith Shaw straight off Mr. Carrickham with Ali.
Yeah, thanks, Nick. I've got Keith with me. First British rider clear, and a bit of local support you had here.
Yeah, it's nice, and like he has won a four-star Grand Prix once in Austria last year. But from here last year, I ended up going home on the Monday morning and breaking my pelvis, so I was off for 16 weeks, so it's been quite hard coming back.
Bet it has, and yeah, I mean, how long have you been back competing at this top level?
At the top level, I started back riding in September, but probably shouldn't have done, really. I was in a lot of pain and couldn't really walk very well. But now it's not so bad.
he's sort of the horse that's kept you going, I imagine, in terms of having something at the top level.
Yeah, it's one to get out of bed for in the morning anyway.
Look, that makes all the more remarkable, and good luck.
Thank you.
It's obviously been a very difficult 12 months for Keith. He's feeling the emotions there. So just the four clears so far, but John Whittaker is in the arena. So back to you, Nick.
Thanks, Ali. You can use all the superlatives in the world, but none really do describe this man's talents. And he's riding still better than ever, you would suggest, Tim. The old Lodge Stud's Lord of Arabia.
John, and being at the top of his game, how many times we've said it, but he's just riding unbelievable at the moment. So much confidence and so much determination for the amount of years he's been doing it. Look at this here, he's full thrown himself.
Fabulous.
Out.
Second clear for Great Britain, John Whittaker, Keith Shaw. John, he's unbelievable, isn't he?
He's a man under himself, he really is. He doesn't know when to quit.
Brilliant. So Will Whittaker, the man who took the honours 12 months ago. Ambassador here for Ashford Farm Bolesworth. Now, what can he do? Can he join Uncle John?
Ooh. He's taking a little bit of a grab there, and he's quite a strong horse, and maybe Will disguises it very well because of the position. But you see sometimes, like there, he's really having to work hard to contain the adrenaline and the strength of Fandango.
So there are five clears at the moment. Then we've got the four falters making up that top 13. Steady, Will.
Will be thinking purely about the clear at the moment. He won't be thinking too much about the time. So much power this horse has, but sometimes it can just get away from him. So Will's got to be careful. And if he puts too much aspect of time, then the speed can just get them to make a mistake, so it's really a balancing act. You wouldn't have liked your finger on that one.
No, you wouldn't. Now,
not ideal the line here.
No.
Whoa,
steady.
The vertical going in.
You could actually see that coming from the last line, really, Tim, couldn't you?
I don't think any of us were surprised that it happened, but Will was really working hard.
Yeah.
Just caught him out. Just kept running down that line. And you saw there the trajectory all wrong, the balance all wrong.
And it's eight faults, it can be the cruelest of sports. Now, Yasmin Pinchin for Great Britain, Vanda Vivaldi. She's been enjoying some wonderful form. She was third in that Grand Prix at Royal Windsor, what, a month ago now. And she jumped quite brilliantly in that jump off.
She did. I was in a show in France in Macon where she won the big class there on a class of 65 starters, and she absolutely went to town and gave us all a riding lesson. So Yasmin's well capable of riding well, and this horse has got a great jump, as you just saw there. He's got a lot of power. A little fidgety in the bridle. For those people who are watching, aren't sure, they've got a lot of ear and tail wear on here. They've got the earmuffs on normally because the horse doesn't like flies around his ears. But what we've also got, we've got a ribbon on his tail because he's quite sharp around other horses and he can lash out. So that's just to warn the other riders within the collecting ring. So it's not this is not for pure decoration. These are for a use. Jumping a super round.
Yeah,
super
jumping
round.
Really well.
Again, got to be careful here. Not too much power here and just keep round in the step.
This looks very good, and it is very good. So that's three for Great Britain. Well done, Yasmin. Absolutely brilliant. And look at that time, Tim, 79.89. So she's put herself right in the driving position, hasn't she?
Deceptively quick, but I felt that she was always travelling in the rhythm and got a good tempo throughout.
Really good. So she joins John Whittaker and Keith Shaw for Great Britain. Now the world number one, Scott Brash. And Lady Harris, Lady Kirkham's Hello Forever. We heard him say earlier, not been the easiest of week, only a nine-year-old, but this is a horse that is right up there with Sanctos, or will be.
Relatively new in the partnership, in fairness, and the horse was actually produced in England, bought in Holland, but produced in England. So he's sort of very used to English courses. But Scott and Forever, they are relatively new, and so it just doesn't look as gelled as maybe it could on one or two of his horses. But it's certainly going in the right direction.
Jumping really well. So, you're watching the world's best.
Great balance down there. Scott totally in unison with his horse. Body position, head still.
He is super smooth, isn't he? Super cool.
He's taken a little bit of a run in here, so he's got to take care down this last line. Get him straight, Scott.
Right. Two to go. Oh!
Oh!
What a shame for Scott.
Would you believe it, Tim?
It's that final fence in that
I think we both felt that he jumped that. It was
I mean, I don't know how he touched it. I mean, well, millimetres. So, four faults here. We'll see him in the second round. Bad luck, Scott Brash.
Well, that final fence claiming yet another victim, this time world number one, Scott Brash. It certainly has caused all sorts of trouble. Perhaps that big oxer, the Redrow Homes oxer, is making the horses just to lose their concentration coming into that final double. First round is over. We have six clears, one for Italy, one for Ireland, one for Luxembourg, and three for Great Britain. Keith Shaw, John Whittaker, and Yasmin Pinchin. Second round is coming up. We'll see you then.
Welcome back to Redrow Bolesworth Grand Prix Day, and Ali is with one of the clears, the great John Whittaker.
So John, they're just finishing preparing the course for the second round, but first react to a very good clear in the first round.
Yeah, very pleased, jumped fantastic. I felt even over number one and two he was jumping, and yeah, it's a difficult course. Also, it's a really tight time, and that kind of messes you up really, trying to get inside the time, but no, I knew it was quite tough, but the standards high.
Still very much to play for. Robert, though, thought that your horse would be suited by this second round and the course. He seems to be jumping very well, Lord of Arabia.
Yeah, the only thing is, he's used the second time in, he's used to going fast, so he's going to think he's going fast, so I'll have to try and keep him under control, but he's, yeah, so far so good. He jumped great.
So far so good indeed, and good luck in the second round.
Thank you.
Good luck indeed, John. There's Lee Pearson, the Paralympic multiple gold medalist, and Nina Barber, the inspiration behind the Bolesworth four-star, and that's the order for the second round. Dan Nielsen will be going first. Edwina Tops Alexander for Australia, Christian Vaar, the first of the clears for Luxembourg, and then last to go, Yasmin Pinchin. We've got six clears in the Redrow Homes Grand Prix. Time very important, but the first thing that they've got to do is jump a clear, and bad luck there for Dan Nielsen. So he carries four from the first round and four from the second round. And Edwina jumps the last fence and she has it down, so she finishes on eight. Anthony gives us the first clear in the second round, the Arco bred horse, the Hells is Aristio. So now can he climb up the list? Dermot Lennon, so unlucky in the first round with that last fence down, and he has number 10 Downing Street down as well. Well done to Lorenzo De Luca. He finishes on a good time, 39.42. So his afternoon is done, we would think, because we take all those through on equal penalties through to the jump off. Now, Scott Brash, so unlucky with that last fence down. Now, he's got to get a good clear.
That's right, Nick. The difference of this type of competition with it being three rounds, Scott's already had a fence down, so he's there with four faults. So his time is really important for him to go up. On the other hand, if you're clear, you're trying to jump clear to get to the third round, so your time is indefinitely always going to be slower. So therefore, it hands the advantage back to someone like Scott.
Yes, it
because
does.
He knows what he's got to do. It's a little bit of poker, if you like.
And he jumps a lovely clear. Oh, Scott.
That's going to move him right up the ranks.
That is going to pull him up. And look at that time, 37.03, so quicker than Lorenzo De Luca. So now those six clears that we've got have got to jump clear. If they have a fence down and it's slower than 37.03, Scott climbs the rankings.
And they drop down.
And they drop down.
And so there's a slight imbalance to a certain extent, but it's really crucial, clear rounds.
Laura. Heliodor Hybris. Now, she gave a really fast four faults in the first round. Ooh, Laura.
Very tight turn there. She's on it, and again, another tight inside turn, wasting a second.
That's the double. Oh! So now we have to wait for the time. 36.23. But she finishes on a total of eight, so she'll drop right down.
Exactly.
Yeah.
This is the conundrum with these three-round competitions.
Last fence goes down.
Chanced her arm a little bit on the turn there. Look, it's a big fence, that last fence. She was really unlucky.
Quartered undersides. So now the man from Luxembourg, Christian Vaier, and his own global. Winner of a really good Grand Prix in Belgium last week. Now this is the first of the clears. So his aim is double clear, isn't it? To make it through to the jump off against the clock.
You already saw that. He went around that fence there. So he's already about 2 seconds slower than maybe Scott Brash was at this stage.
So remember, Scott got round in 37.03.
Difficult double here. He's got a big stretch in, and then he's got a back up. To jump a very flimsy vertical coming out. Chanced his arm, but got there.
Pulling a little bit there, Tim. Now, last fence. And they've had it. Oh, that shake of the head tells the story. And look at that time, 49.39. So now, Christian is dropping down four or five places. It's such a cruel competition, but a fascinating competition,
isn't it? It rewards clear round jumping, as you can see. And that was such a shame, because he really gave the horse room.
So, Italy, Alberto Zorzi, Amore de Seigneur.
Jumped the first round, I thought was really good, really out the top draw. And the horse looks a nice horse in the way that he goes about his work. Nice, pleasant rhythm, using his body correctly.
And he's very much aiming for that clear, isn't he?
Oh, little bit, lacked a bit of panache there off the floor, in fairness.
Impulsion.
A little bit soft, a little bit weak. And that's a very big jump, and you can't just jump fences out of a hand canter.
No, you can't. It's a bit 1.60 vertical, that Cleo B shoe fence. So they finish on a score of four, and the time, 43.16. So Scott Brash has really started to climb the rankings. But we're looking for the double clear. That's the all-important. And will it go to this man? You wouldn't bet against it.
Super careful, Lord of Arabia. Lots of spring, again, using the body right. Watch the back end, it flicks away. John's settling him nicely. John's trademark little kick there with the legs. He's like a little pistons, they go left and right, and the horse responds beautifully from it.
Ooh, spot.
He's taking an extra stride there, but he got away with it. Just the last to jump, John.
And there it is. Absolutely magical. There's the first double clear. I don't know what you say about this man. He's won it all, he's done it all, and he's still doing it all.
He just inspires confidence in the way that he rides his horses, though, doesn't he? You know, he's very much on it.
So that's the first of the double clears, and it belongs to Great Britain. Will it be two? The man who was fifth in this Grand Prix here 12 months ago. Keith Shaw, Mr. Currican.
Again, you can see how much this means to him to be riding back at this level with that interview earlier. He's a good friend of mine, but even I was surprised at the emotion that was there, which is great, because we put a lot into this job, and it's good when things work well for us. And from my point of view, it's great to see Keith riding at this level again.
Keith, that's your first bit of luck.
I think he's going to be okay, because I think the horse, this is the super fence for him. Nice square oxer, breaks his back, lovely.
He joins John Whittaker, and that's two double clears and two for Great Britain. One for Cheshire, one for Yorkshire.
Fabulous round.
Well done, Keith. That's great news. It's a wonderful partnership, this. Really is. Now, Ireland. Former Young Horse Champion at the Horse of the Year show, Trevor Breen, Old Town KC. Riding in their very first four-star Grand Prix.
He's not the youngest of horses, but he's actually been produced up this next level by Trevor and making a very good job. Beautiful looking horse. Very striking in the markings and his white face. When you see him in the flesh, you're really impressed, and you know he's equine athlete all
class.
Over him. Yeah, exactly. Pretty measured there.
The Breen brothers, Trevor and Shane, two of the most stylish jockeys in the world, aren't they?
Very good horsemen.
Good shot, Trev.
Well done, Trevor Breen.
So it's three. Old Town KC, Trevor Breen, Ireland. So two for Great Britain, one for Ireland. So one left to go. Trevor Breen definitely through to the jump off against the clock, along with Keith Shaw and Mr. Currican and John Whittaker and the Old Lodge's Lord of Arabia. It's thrilling at the moment for the £60,000 Grand Prix here at Bolesworth, and there's one left to go, and we'll see that after the break, and it is the ride of Yasmin Pinchin, the lady from Sussex, Vanda Vivaldi. Welcome back to the final phases of the second round here at Bolesworth for the Grand Prix. And the last to go, can she give us the third double clear for Great Britain? Yasmin Pinchin, Vanda Vivaldi. What do you reckon, Tim?
I said earlier on she won a very good class in Macon when I was there, and I was very impressed with her that day. And she certainly moved up these leagues, as it were, and at Windsor she showed again the form wasn't a fluke. So my betting is that she's going to be able to jump a clear round.
Not long to wait.
Very stylish ride, isn't she?
That was super through there.
Copybook.
So the last. Come on, Yasmin. Oh, magnificent. Lovely.
Super round. Very cool, I felt, and didn't get pressured into the situation. She just stuck to her tempo and her rhythm. I thought full marks.
Full marks indeed. 22 years of age and jumped brilliantly. And she'll go last in the jump off against the clock. And it's speed all the way now in the Grand Prix.
Well, we have an exciting jump off to look forward to then. Four double clears through, three for Great Britain and one for Ireland. They'll jump in the same order as they did in that second round. So first into the arena will be John Whittaker, then Keith Shaw, then Trevor Breen. And finally, the youngster, Yasmin Pinchin, at 22 years old, wanting to put one over her British teammate. So they're just altering the course. It's going to be a shortened track for this jump off. But importantly, that influential final fence in the first round is going to be the final fence in this jump off.
John Whittaker gets us underway in the jump off against the clock in the Redrow Holmes Grand Prix. Lord of Arabia. What's his tactics? Fast?
Difficult to call, only four in it. He doesn't want to leave it too open, but he's got to lend something to try and beat.
Now he's got to pick up the pace.
Now, that wasn't one that I had John struggling with. Maybe something like that one wouldn't be a Lord of Arabia's perfect fence.
Two fences down.
Lost a bit of concentration there, John. You can see he was just quite expecting. Now, the last two fences are both two very big oxes.
Here comes the last. Jumps it. But it's two fences down, 38.01 there for John Whittaker, Lord of Arabia. It is a total
of 8, the 2 go down. There's John, I can't see that winning that today.
No, I can't. And looking to set the best standard that he can. Trick about this competition is clears, 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 isn't it?
In three-round competitions, that's the name of the game. It's, and horses have got to be fit and strong because there's a lot of jumping in three rounds.
In a two-round competition, you could win it with a fast four faults, but I don't know. We've got three to watch, and here's the first of those three. Keith Shaw, Mr. Currican.
Now, there he took one less stride than Johnny. Went down there on the 6, and I think he just ran out of room coming into that. Quite a big, powerful horse and just kept travelling. So that was the risk that Keith did. He's probably looking behind him at the 2 to follow.
Oh, and that vertical's gone. Number 10, Darling Street, has gone. So John was home in 38.01.
Again, you see him
holding. He's going to drop down.
Yeah, that's right. It's
he's dropped down. So John Whittaker goes up into, well, first at the moment with 2 left to go, could finish in 3rd. Bad luck, Keith.
That was surprising. Keith got a little bit of travelling they saw there. The horse was just running out of distance, really. 2 strides in there, a little bit short.
Trevor Breen, the sole challenger for Ireland, Old Town KC.
He has got a little bit of margin here because John and Keith both had 2 fences down. So I think there, Trevor will be just going a little bit more on the side of caution.
The Coffees, Old Town KC. Right, come on, Trev. Based in Buckinghamshire. 2 to go.
Super turn there.
2 to go.
Get straight.
Come on. Oh! And he has the last 38.94, but he's finishing above John Whittaker and Keith Shaw at the moment. 38.94 is the time. Oh. With Old Town KC. Can anybody magic this course of Bob Ellis and Kelvin Bywaters?
It's a very big auction. Like I said, we've done 3 rounds of jumping. Not a lot to back them off. And as you saw there, the horse just jumped straight at it.
So the last to go. Can she give us the treble clear? Yasmin Pinchin and Vanda Vivaldi.
A lot of pressure on here. She's got to just stick to her game plan, stay in her rhythm.
Trevor's time, 38.94. And he had the last down. This could be the biggest moment of her career so far.
Got to stay cool.
Lovely now, over there.
Get these
right,
last
Yasmin.
2 fences jumped.
She's got a good time, Tim. Come on, Yasmin. Oh, brilliant.
Superb.
Absolutely brilliant.
Superb, superb, superb. Lot of pressure, and you see what it means to
her.
Oh,
that. Look at
fabulous.
That.
Fabulous.
Look at that. It makes it all the worthwhile. All the early mornings, all the late nights. She wins the Redrow Homes Grand Prix here at Bolesworth. And the smile, Tim, says it all.
A fantastic performance throughout. Fabulous 3 rounds of jumping, and to remain as cool as she did at the end was brilliant.
The smiles.
Look at that last fence. Wow. Fantastic. She knows she just won.
£20,000 and the Grand Prix at a 4-star international. Just amazing. Wonderful smiles. So there's the full result. And so many congratulations. Yasmin Pinchin wins her first 4-star international Grand Prix. Trevor Breen, the Coffees Old Town KC, goes second, then John Whittaker, and then Keith Shaw. And Scott Brash, the world number one, climbed and finishes in 5th. A fabulous Grand Prix.
Sorry.
Yasmin, come and have a chat. Congratulations. Well, it means a huge amount to you.
I've never won a Grand Prix in my life. This is incredible. Best feeling ever. It's like the best horse I've ever had in my life.
He's been a real star. What was it like knowing that you just had to jump clear that final fence?
Absolutely awful. And like, I tapped one. I was like, oh my God. But he did it. He knew what he had to do. I told him before.
Let's see the, how much we're shaking. Oh, but this is obviously the biggest win in your career.
Yes, definitely. And off to Monaco next week. So this is like so exciting now. We're on a roll.
And to beat all those other superstars. I mean, the world number one beating him, John Whittaker.
I know. See, us girls can do it.
Fantastic. Look, enjoy the moment and well done.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
Oh, Tim, what a wonderful interview. I don't know how to put it into words, but that was just fabulous, wasn't it?
Well, the emotions coming through. To win your first Grand Prix on home soil, it'd be a big one as well, a four-star Grand Prix with the top riders there. It just means so much, and you can see.
Joanne Whittaker, Laura Rennick, Scott Brash, all congratulating her. The crowd staying for the presentation, so richly deserved. And what a fabulous competition. Three rounds of pure jumping.
This has been a superb event, and full marks to Nina and her team because they made a really great job of it.
Yes, they did. There's Steve Morgan from Redrow Homes, Nina Barber on the right, and congratulating Yasmin Pinchin and Vanda Vivaldi. A fabulous Grand Prix. The castle in the background, a magnificent setting, and pure show jumping. Tremendous. And John Whittaker finishes in third.
Well, Nina, what an event it's been, and what a fantastic result with Yasmin Pinchin winning the Grand Prix.
Absolutely, what a great end to the show. I think it's probably one of Yasmin's biggest wins of her career. It was a big track, three rounds of serious jumping, and she really deserved to win it.
That's not the end of the Bolesworth story. There's another big event to look forward to.
Absolutely, we've got our new venture, which is the Liverpool International Horse Show, scheduled to run at the Echo Arena in Liverpool from the 1st to the 3rd of January this year. So the minute we finished on this one, it's on with our exciting new plans for the next one.
Congratulations on this event, and we look forward to that. Thank you very much. But it's been quite a day, quite a victory for 22-year-old Yasmin Pinchin. I'm sure she's not going to forget this day for a long time. She's beat many Olympian in today's lineup. Will Yasmin Pinchin be a star of the future? Will she be a star for some British teams, British Olympic teams? That's it from our coverage here in Cheshire. I hope you've enjoyed it. We'll see you very soon.